100% completing Super Mario Sunshine is not exactly the easiest task in the world. Sometimes it feels like the game was literally designed to frustrate you, with some of the missions being so controller-throwingly hard that they'll make you want to question your life decisions altogether. And of course, one of the hardest parts of fully completing this game is trying to find all those dreaded blue coins. Not only are the vast majority of them hidden in some of the most cryptic places in the entire game, but there's just so many of them to collect. A whopping 240 of them to be exact. They're flipping everywhere in this game. But have no fear, Mario the Mastermind is here. Today, I'm going to show you exactly where all those pesky blue coins are located, so you won't have to suffer through all the pain and agony trying to find them yourself. I'll be starting off with all 20 blue coins in Delfino Plaza first, and then working my way up to all the other levels in the game later on. So now, without any further ado, let's embark on this extravagant coin hunt. First, grab onto the sewer grate in front of the Pianta statue and keep moving north until you reach the big water area with a whole bunch of coins. You should then be able to find your first blue coin in the uppermost section of the sewer area next to the dock on the right. I hope these sewers Mario's traveling through are clean. Then, head back over to the Pianta statue and you'll see a big red X on the right side of it. X marks the spot after all. Spraying it with water will cause a blue coin to appear at the edge of the dock near the boathouse. But keep in mind that you have to grab it quickly before it disappears. If you don't make it in time, you can always just go back and spray the red X a second time and try again. No biggie. The next blue coin is of course the exact same thing, only in reverse. Here's what I mean by that. Right where you picked up your blue coin on the dock, you'll see another red X on the wall in front of you. Spraying that red X will cause another blue coin to appear next to the right side of the Pianta statue. So go ahead and quickly grab that blue coin before it's too late. Make your way to the jail cell you were just thrown into at the beginning of the game, and you'll notice a blue coin from the inside. To get it, use the hover nozzle to float over the water and into a little opening in the back of the building. You can enter this building in order to find yourself yet another marvelous blue coin. I mean, the Pianta police officers obviously trusted Mario not to escape from out of this big white opening in the jail cell. They just wanted him to have a nice little view, that's all. Go ahead and grab the turbo nozzle from behind the Pianta statue and zoom your way across the water and over to the chain of cylinder-shaped islands near the Gelato Beach Tower. On the side of one of the islands, you'll find a gate that can only be smashed through with a turbo nozzle. So just smash right through it and lo and behold, there's a blue coin from the inside! Hooray! Head over to the area where the two Pianta police officers are guarding the gate to one of the secret shrines in Delfino Plaza. This is where you'll find a burning Pianta just running all around like a flippin' maniac. He can't put the fire out himself because he just won't stand still. Stop, drop, and roll, you big silly goose. So after you put out his fire with Flood, just walk up and talk to him and he'll give you a shiny blue coin for saving his life. What a nice guy. And now for quite possibly the most annoying blue coins in Delfino Plaza. Maybe even the entire game. Go behind the building with a Serena Beach pipe on top of it, and you'll find a purple Pianta lady standing next to a little fruit basket on the ground. Talk to her and she'll ask you to go out and bring her 3 bananas to drop into her fruit basket. You can find the bananas in the area where all the Piantas are selling a wide variety of fruits. After this is done, talk to her a second time and she'll give you a wonderful blue coin. Yeah, apparently she's too lazy to just go out and get the dang bananas herself, so of course, she forces me to go fetch them instead. I mean, why would I want to complete a video game task where all I'm doing is chores? Isn't that what video games are supposed to help us avoid doing? Next, head over to the Shine Gate and you'll find a yellow Pianta lady on the right side of it. This time, she wants you to bring her 3 pineapples and place them into her fruit basket. The problem is, the fruit basket is really high off the ground for whatever reason, so you have to carefully aim your pineapple shots and throw them into the fruit basket in just the right spot. 3 times in a row. I mean, why not lower the fruit basket just a little bit for me to jump inside of and drop the fruit into? It can't be that hard, right? And by far the worst blue coin is this one right over here. You'll notice a pink Pianta lady standing next to the left side of the Shine Gate. She wants you to bring her 3 durians. Now at first you might think to yourself, what the heck is a durian? Then you realize it's the only fruit in the entire game that you can't pick up and carry. Instead, all you can do with it is just kinda kick it around like a flippin' soccer ball. You also don't have much control over it either, which is why this blue coin is known for being so aggravating. All I can say for this one is good luck. Before we get to the fourth and final blue coin fetch quest in Delfino Plaza, let's go ahead and grab a few more regular blue coins before I end up getting a flippin' coronary. If you head back over to where the yellow pineapple Pianta lady was, you'll come across a big crate on the edge of the dock next to the Shine Gate. Busting it open will reveal a mysterious red M on the Shine Gate's wall, and spraying the M with Flood will cause a magnificent blue coin to pop out. Oh, and remember kids, M stands for Make Money 420. Keep that in mind. Head over to the sewer grate near the pink durian Pianta lady and ground pound through it. Then turn right and head north until you get to another big coin-filled water area. Keep going north until you eventually stumble across another terrific blue coin. Right where the sewer grate was located, bounce on top of one of the umbrellas in order to reach the nearby rooftop. Then use your hover nozzle to glide your way over to this other building, where you'll see another Make Money 420M located on the tower's wall to your left. Simply spray it down with Flood and you got yourself yet another amazing blue coin. From there, head over to the lonely sewer grate in between the boathouse and the big cannon that launches you to Peanut Park. Ground pound through it and then head out into the direction of the ocean. Keep heading that way until you can eventually make a left. From that direction, head north again and continue making your way through the zigzaggy pathway until you finally stumble across yet another phenomenal blue coin. And now for the fourth and final blue coin fetch quest. I figured I might as well get it out of the way now while I still can. After making your way back from the zigzaggy pathway, make a right and then head north until you eventually reach a lonely island. This is where you'll see an orange Pianta lady, who wants you to bring her 3 coconuts this time. Now thankfully, you don't have to keep making your way back and forth from the fruit stand to the island. Instead, there's a whole bunch of coconuts growing on the palm tree in the middle. So just simply spray down one of the coconuts from the tree and toss it into the good old fruit basket over there. Rinse and repeat a couple more times, talk to the lady, and then collect your blue coin. And best of all, you don't even have to worry about running out of coconuts here, because the tree will immediately grow them back when they're all gone. Man, if only I had a tree like this one. Whew, boy am I glad I got all those blue coins out of the way. And now, back to the normal stuff again. Next, launch yourself straight out of the lonely sewer grate on the other side of the water, and just hover your way over to this rooftop near the boathouse. This is where you'll find another big crate that you can smash, and doing so will reveal yet another 420M on the other side of the tower's wall. Spray it down with Flood, and then before you know it, another blue coin is officially yours for the taking. Head over to the green rooftop on the other side where you'll come across a hungry Yoshi egg. Bring him whatever fruit he desperately desires and hop on his back. Then, make your way over to the rooftop with the Serena Beach pipe on top of it. Near the pipe as well, you'll find a whole bunch of birds just kinda chilling on the rooftop. But the one bird you wanna go after is the blue one, because he's the one who has the next blue coin you're looking for. So just gobble him up with Yoshi's tongue and then it's blue coin time. If you don't have Yoshi with you for this task, you can always try and spray down the bird with Flood, but this is more difficult to do, plus it takes longer, so I would recommend using Yoshi for this one if you just wanna get it over with rather quickly. Nothing wrong with eating birds, totally normal thing to do. Over on the other side of the sage near the Shine Gate, you'll come across another blue bird on one of the rooftops that either Yoshi or Flood can take care of. Once that's done, go ahead and grab your coin. From that exact same rooftop, look up at the nearby tower on your left and you'll notice a whole bunch of strange yellow goop that's walking off a little opening at the top of the tower. Simply spray it with Yoshi's regurgitated love juice in order to make it all melt away. Then, head all the way up to that little opening on top and nab the blue coin from inside. Remember, this will not work with just the regular Flood nozzle. Gee, I wonder how Yoshi feels about this after losing his lunch like that. Next, head over to the area where the yellow pineapple Pianta lady is and make your way on top of the nearby rooftop next to her. This is where you'll find another wall of strange yellow goop for Yoshi to spray his magical love juice onto, causing it to once again melt away and reveal yet another blue coin for you to snatch. Again, this will not work with Flood. And finally, for this last blue coin, you'll need to do a little bit of traveling. Allow me to explain. Before you even do anything at all, you'll need to grab at least 10 coins in Delfino Plaza. Then, head over to the edge of the dock near the boathouse and give your 10 coins to the orange Pianta in the hat and sunglasses. Doing this will allow him to take you to the place where you got your very first shine sprite from, Delfino Airstrip. Once you get there, go ahead and grab the turbo nozzle next to the big red coin button. You can then use the turbo nozzle in order to smash your way through one of the gates on either side of the nearby tower. Once this is done, you'll notice the final blue coin from inside the tower, completely encapsulated in a big block of ice. Simply spray the ice block with Flood in order to make it melt away, and then bada bing bada boom, the last blue coin is yours for keeps. So that's where you can officially find all 20 blue coins in Delfino Plaza. Was this video helpful? Let me know in the comments below. Until then, and stay tuned for the next scavenger hunt where we try and hunt down all 30 blue coins in the beautiful grassy plains of Bianco Hills. See you guys then!